Hi, I'm Dr. Adam Marsh. I'm the lead paleontologist at Petrified Forest National Park. Welcome to Dinosaur Day. Not a dinosaur, not a dinosaur, not a dinosaur, not a dinosaur. That's a dinosaur. Today we're celebrating the anniversary of Gertie the dinosaur, our own Chindisaurus, Brian Smalleye from Petrified Forest National Park. This is a virtual question and answer session. From @pauseforreaction on Twitter, where in the world have most dinosaur fossils been discovered? Most dinosaur fossils have been discovered in North America, China, and Argentina, but dinosaurs have been found in every continent all over the globe, including Antarctica. @halahezy on Instagram asks, is it true that a chick is the closest relative to T-Rex? Birds are one group of dinosaurs, so all birds are more closely related to each other than they are other kinds of dinosaurs. The most closely related animal to T-Rex are its tyrannosaurid cousins, Albertosaurus and Daspletosaurus. So Tyrannosaurus and a chick are more closely related to each other than they are to something like Stegosaurus, but they're not one another's closest relatives. @mweench on Instagram asked, what was the average life expectancy of dinosaurs? It's hard to constrain the age and life expectancy in fossil organisms, especially if they don't have any living close relatives. We do know that life expectancy and age tends to vary even within a certain kind of animal group, with body size and ecology and metabolism. So something like a hummingbird has a 3 to 5 year life expectancy, whereas an ostrich might live for 45 years. Now, we can cut dinosaur limb bones in cross-section, polish them up, and look at them in a microscope. And in some cases, they lay down rings, almost like a tree. And we can look at annual growth rings. And in that way, we found that an animal like Sue, the Tyrannosaurus rex, is around 28 years old. But something like a long-necked Apatosaurus might live for more than 70 years. @salam_Dylan on Instagram asked, did your paleontologist finish the Smilosuchus fossil skull? What this person's referring to is a large phytosaur skull that we collected in 2016, and it's been in our fossil preparation lab, essentially getting the rock cleaned off of it since then. There's been a lot of work done since we've posted on it on Instagram. Right now, the back end of the jaw is being carefully taken apart, cleaned off, and then put back together, and eventually we'll remove the lower jaw from the upper jaw so that we can make it more safe in the museum. @LeafNorman on Instagram asked, what is the reason for feathered saurischians? Is there an evolutionary reason? Saurischians are the group of dinosaurs to which meat-eating and long-necked dinosaurs belong, because these are the theropods and the sauropodomorphs. Now, we know that not all saurischians have been found with feathers in the fossil record. In fact, only specific kinds of saurischian theropod dinosaurs have been found with feathers. No sauropodomorph or long-necked dinosaurs have been found with feathers. Now, people think that feathers might belong to a larger group like the saurischians because of the presence of what are called pycnofibers in pterosaurs, which are the closely related flying reptiles. Pycnofibers are a almost filamentous feather-like structure that are probably developmentally very similar to feathers. Now, is there an evolutionary reason for feathers? Not necessarily. There doesn't have to be a reason that we have the different physical traits that we have. For example, there is a difference between exaptation and adaptation. You hear about adaptation being a physical characteristic that something has that may or may not make it better suited for its environment. What happened with feathers is probably what's called exaptation, where feathers or feather-like structures existed for a purpose like thermoregulation, and then were later exapted or used for a different purpose, in this case, flight. @TheSafariHiker on Instagram asked, what is the earliest dinosaur known? The earliest unambiguous dinosaurs are Eoraptor, Eodromius, and Herrerasaurus. These are from the Ischigualasto Formation in Argentina, and they're about 230 million years old. The oldest dinosaurs that we have from the park are about 220 million years old. @MrProtocol on Twitter asked, when we bring dinosaurs back, will it be from recovered DNA or from analysis of inactive DNA from their modern descendants, which are birds? Well, unfortunately, we're not going to be bringing them back. Even though DNA can survive in the fossil record for almost 1 million years, DNA is meant to unravel and decay. Otherwise, it could not unravel and get replicated in cells millions and millions of times every minute. As far as we know, inactive sections of extant DNA doesn't code for specific traits of long extinct organisms. For example, things that make long-necked dinosaurs long-necked dinosaurs may or may not be coded in inactive parts of a chicken's DNA. Did you know that up to 8% of the human DNA is actually viral in origin? At Adam G. Plogman on Instagram asked, "What are the types of dinosaurs you've recovered fossils from in the park? Are there more common ones that you find?" Well, there are two kinds of dinosaurs that we find in the park. One is called Chindisaurus, and the other is an animal like Coelophysis, which is known from hundreds of individuals from Ghost Ranch, New Mexico. They're equally abundant relative to each other, but they're actually pretty rare compared to the other kinds of fossils we find in the park. At devil.megs on Instagram asked, "What is the oldest dinosaur fossil that has been recovered in the park, and to what did it belong to? How did dinosaurs survive in Petrified Forest?" The oldest dinosaur that we found is something like Coelophysis, and it's the upper part of the shin bone of that animal. It's about 220 million years old. Petrified Forest didn't always look like this. In fact, it's only looked the way it has for the last maybe several thousand years. Back 220 million years ago, Petrified Forest would have looked a lot like Costa Rica, and Coelophysis would have not had any problem running around in the coniferous forest and finding food and friends. At D0Bucks on Instagram asked, "How many dinosaur species have been discovered so far?" Well, it's actually pretty hard to tell fossil species apart from each other. Unlike modern biologists who have colors and behaviors and specific features that we can use to tell species apart, a lot of that doesn't fossilize. We do know that more than 500 species of dinosaurs have been named in the fossil record, but there's an estimate that 2,500 or more probably existed throughout the Mesozoic. Birds, for example, living birds, exceed 10,000 species, which are all dinosaurs. At Polaroid_Dreamer on Instagram asked, "Have any feathers been preserved on any of the dino finds in the park?" Feathers have not been found in any Triassic dinosaur. The oldest feather belongs to something like Archaeopteryx, which is about 150 million years old. That's almost 80 million years after the animals that were alive in the Triassic were around. At Donald Albert on Instagram asked, "How do you know what dinosaurs sound like?" We don't have any idea what dinosaurs sound like. If you watch Jurassic Park, they made dinosaur noises with modern animals. They made the Tyrannosaurus noise with a slowed down baby elephant. And they made the Velociraptor noises with mating turtles and angry geese. Because birds are dinosaurs, we suspect that at least some dinosaurs had the vocalization organ in birds called the syrinx. So many dinosaurs probably sounded a lot more like birds than they do things like lions. At stormy6592_18 on Instagram asked, "What types of food did the dinosaurs in Petrified Forest survive on? How did they survive against their predators?" The two types of dinosaurs we get at Petrified Forest are both meat-eating theropod dinosaurs, Coelophysis and Chindisaurus. They're eating primarily meat and probably insects. Now, most of the predators in the time are not dinosaurs, but they were eating dinosaurs. Some of them were ambush predators and lurking in bogs, ponds, streams. We understand that dinosaurs may or may not have relatively higher metabolic processes than the animals around them, and perhaps they could have avoided their predators by running away, but it wasn't always successful. Thanks for coming to our virtual question and answer session for Dinosaur Day. We look forward to seeing you all here in the park again soon. Thanks to those who submitted questions, and check back on our social media for more Dinosaur Day activities.